of any state are broken, a duly authorized organization swings into action. It may be called the state police, state troopers, militia, the rangers, or the highway patrol. These are the stories of the men whose training, skill, and courage have enforced and preserved our state laws. Much of a law enforcement officer's work is routine. On August 18th, the head of the Highway Patrol was making an ordinary inspection tour of outlying patrol stations. But the atmosphere in the isolated community of Larchmont was anything but ordinary.
Sorry, mister. I'm not going to be able to give you anything. My stove just went on the blink.
That's too bad. Any place else in town I can get something, Dick?
Oh, yes, sir. There's John's place right across the street, if he's open. And if he's not, there's a place about 3 miles back on the main highway.
Thanks. I hope you get your stove fixed.
Answer it.
Hello?
Charlie?
Yes.
Listen, a man just came into town, a stranger. He's driving a highway patrol car.
What's he wanting?
I don't know, maybe nothing. But I'd like to get him out of here. Listen, I've got to call John.
Jenny said a highway patrol officer just rode in.
Chances are he's just passing through.
Maybe. Maybe not. Could be they followed Walker. Maybe they trailed him here.
Suppose we just wait and find out, huh? What do you think, Doc?
You got nothing to lose now.
The front door locked?
I don't know.
Good morning. Heard you're working inside. It's the first sound I've heard since I drove in town. Why is everything closed up?
I don't know.
I noticed a doctor's car by the general store. I wonder if he had anything to do with everything being shut.
Huh?
You know, sickness, epidemic, something like that.
I don't know.
Looks like he's heading for his car.
Yeah. For a minute, I thought he was going inside the garage. That's all we need for him to see what Eddie's doing.
I couldn't get Frank to take anything. He's still upset about Walker. Wants to wait till later. After it's over, get him to take a couple of capsules, will you? I left a bottle on the table.
Okay.
That man from the patrol still in town?
Looks like he's leaving now.
Yeah. He's getting into his car. You better wait a minute, Doc.
to 2150.
My 1020 is Larchmont. You headed this way?
My ETA is 1 hour.
You know Larchmont pretty well, don't you?
Yes, I pass it there a couple of times a day. If you're hungry, you can eat at Jenny's. Pretty good food, too.
She's closed. So is everybody else. Ever known a whole town to close down at the start of a business day?
No, never have. Why, is that what's happening?
Yeah. See you in about an hour.
10-4.
Oh, doctor. Good morning. Anything wrong around here?
Wrong? Not that I know of.
I noticed a physician's insignia on your car when I drove in. With everything starting to close up, I thought there was an epidemic of some kind or other.
Oh, no, nothing like that. I've just been treating Frank Wilkins. He owns the general store. An attack of nerves. Nothing serious at all. Well, I've got to be on my way.
Doctor, I need some cigarettes. You think I might be able to get some in the store?
It's closed. Somebody was in there taking care of Frank. I don't know if they're still there.
Sorry, mister. We're closed.
Yeah, I know. Doc said I might be able to get some cigarettes here, and I hate to drive without them.
Okay. Wait a minute.
Yeah, I'll wait.
Told you he was trailing Walker. He's going to want to come in here and look around. He'll find you.
Shut up. All he wants is these cigarettes. Two bits, mister.
Thanks. I got some change here someplace. How's Wilkins doing?
He's all right.
Doc fixed his leg up real good.
Yeah, his leg's gonna be okay.
That's what I thought.
He's going down the back. Walker's car, it's out back.
Will you check it?
Here, take the keys. Get out there and drive it away. Take it to your place.
No, Wally. I don't like it. Not now. Not with this guy snooping around.
All right, so you don't like it. When you get to your place, stay there.
You mean I don't have to be in on the rest of it?
No, I can go.
Wilkins?
No, sir. I was just getting some stuff in the store. If you want anything, go around the front there and knock.
Thanks, but I'm just killing some time. I don't see many out-of-state cars. Whose is it?
It's mine. I bought it from a fella a couple of weeks ago.
It's about time you got new license plates for it, isn't it?
Yeah, I know all about that. See, I'm waiting for a registration slip. The fella's gonna sell it to me.
$21.50 to Menlo.
Menlo to $21.50.
1028 and 29. Arizona license number 2 John 11414.
Arizona 2 John 11414. Menlo to 2150. I've got a 503.
2150, bye.
2 John 11414 is listed as stolen from Yuma, Arizona on August 11th. Yuma PD file number 565673. Registration reading...
Okay, I'll get the rest later.
10-4.
2150 to 1730.
1730 to 2150.
Have you noticed a convertible with Arizona plates around Larchmont lately?
Negative. What's up?
I don't know. This man got into the convertible and back at the general store. Said he bought it a couple of weeks ago. He didn't even know how to start it. I just got a 503 on it, stolen from Yuma last week.
Yuma? Nobody around Larchmont's been away from there that I know of. I get all the gossip from Jenny Crane.
Well, this man's about 5'8", gray hair, mustache, wears overalls. He's a farmer type. I'd say he's in his 60s.
Sounds like it might be Charlie Barrett.
Charlie Barrett. Well, I'll find out more about him later. Get here in a hurry. Code 3.
Right. 10-4.
Yeah?
Open up.
Sorry, we're closed.
I'm a policeman. I want to talk to you. What's your name?
Wally Sanders.
Where's Wilkins?
He's in the back room. Sleep. Doc said he shouldn't be disturbed.
Tell me, who was the guy who came out back a little while ago, got in a new convertible and drove off?
Charlie Barrett.
Who owns the car, do you know?
Charlie's been driving around.
For how long?
Well, I don't know. I saw it for the first time myself today.
Where does he live?
2 miles up the old road. That's the farm with the white fence around it. You can't miss it.
I'll be back in a little while. I want to talk to you and Wilkins. Where are you going to be?
We'll be here all day.
Okay.
Make it look bad for Charlie. No time to phone him now, though. He's on his own. Honey, I want you to go to Eddie. Tell him to bring the truck around back. I'll get Walker.
Wally, I'm a little scared. If anything happens to...
Honey, nothing's going to happen.
Barrett and the stolen convertible were the first tangible leads to follow in this strange community.
Hey. Ah. You Charlie Barrett?
Yeah.
I'm Matthews, Highway Patrol. About this car. You say it's yours?
Yeah.
Let me see the bill of sale, will you?
Where? Well, a man's gonna send it to me.
What man? Come on, where'd you get the car?
Well, you see, it's not really mine. I stole it.
Where?
Phoenix.
When?
2-3 weeks ago.
Stand against the car and get your hands over your head. Come on. All right, get in the car. We're going back to town.
All right, Frank.
2150 to 1730.
1730, by him.
I'm coming in with Charlie Barrett. There's somebody else might know what's going on, too. It's a local doctor. Drives a broken-down coupe. Do you know him?
That's Doc Taylor. I go right by his place, Dan. You want me to pick him up?
Yeah, bring him in. I want to ask him some questions.
Okay. Then, Charlie Barrett steal that car?
Said he did. Said he stole it 3 weeks ago in Phoenix. Our make is a week ago in Yuma. I'll see you at the general store.
10-4.
Check all the stores. Bring in anybody you find.
Right.
All right, Charlie. I've got a few questions I want to ask you. What are you doing here?
I just came over to see how Frank was getting along.
Where is he? In the back?
No, he's gone out.
Out? Where?
Into the city, I think.
Where's Wally Sanders?
Well, he's out, too. He took Frank.
You're Jenny Crane, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me. How did Frank manage to walk out of here with that broken leg of his?
Oh, well, Wally carried him to the car.
Oh, I see. What's back there?
Nothing, just a room.
I told you we wouldn't get away with this.
Shut up.
I'm not taking the blame for anyone.
Hi, Jenny.
Hi, Hank.
Where's Miss Matthews?
He's in the back room.
Where is everybody? What's going on around here, Jenny?
Nothing, Hank. Nothing at all.
Everybody's gone, Dan. There's not a soul around.
You take a look back there, too. Jenny, wait a minute. Who was cleaning up back there?
Well, I guess I was.
What caused all the blood?
Wally was doing some work with a knife, and he cut himself.
I see. Well, what do you make of it, Hank?
Like a body was hidden in the closet and then dragged out across the floor.
Yeah, I'm with you. Doc! Was it Wilkins? Is that why you're here?
No, sir.
Who was it then? Doctor, you said you were treating Wilkins for a nervous ailment. Both Jenny and Saunders think it's a broken leg. Now I'm asking you, what went on here?
I'm sorry, Mr. Matthews. I've told you everything I can.
Doc, what kind of talk is that? I thought you were a friend of mine. Now, why don't you answer Mr. Matthews' questions?
Doctor, we know that you medical men observe a strict code of ethics. We're police officers, and we're asking for your cooperation.
You don't have to remind me of my oath, Mr. Matthews. I just hope that when you've put in as many years in your business as I have in mine, you'll have the same feeling of pride in the things you've done.
What happened, Charlie?
I don't know. I don't know.
He went out the back door a while ago. He must have seen something.
I don't know. I don't know.
Wally cut himself. That's all that happened. Isn't that right, Charlie?
Now, look, Charlie. You're in enough trouble over a stolen car. That's a felony. Now, don't make it any tougher on yourself.
Somebody got hurt here today, Charlie. Hurt real bad. Maybe even killed. As far as I'm concerned, you could have killed him. All right, Hank. Take him to the sheriff's office and book him. Book him on suspicion of murder.
I didn't do it. I swear it. I can prove it. Jenny, tell him I didn't kill him.
Shut your mouth.
No, not anymore. All you care about is Wally. I'm not going to take the blame. I did all I could to help, like everybody else. But now I'm through.
Well, then can't you just shut up? Do you have to keep talking?
Go on, Charlie.
Wilkins. Frank Wilkins killed him. The rest of us were only trying to help Frank cover it up. Well, I knew I shouldn't get mixed up in this thing in the first place. I knew we'd be found out.
Who did Wilkins kill?
His name was Walker. I never saw the man before in my life. He came into town last night. He was the one that had the convertible.
Why did he kill him?
It was self-defense.
Self-defense? That doesn't gel. How was it self-defense?
Well, he attacked Frank.
Well, where are they now, Wally and Frank and the others?
They're down at the hollow.
Is this true, Charlie?
Yes, sir.
You know where it is?
Yes, sir.
All right, we go. Doc, Charlie, you too. Come on. Jenny. I'm not through with you yet.
I'm not going anyplace. I'll be right here whenever you want me.
You'll be making a big mistake if you're not.
Hurry it up.
You want to say some kind of a prayer for him, Frank?
I've said 1,000 prayers for him. I haven't any left to say now.
Come on, open it up.
I told him, Frank. I'm sorry.
That's all right, Charlie. Maybe it's just as well. I'm glad to get it off my chest. I killed him.
What happened?
He came into the store last night about 4 a.m. Said the police were looking for him. Told me I'd have to hide him out. I fixed him something to eat. While he was eating, I went out into the store to the phone. I was going to call the police. He came out and found me. He hit me. There was a kerosene lamp on the floor where I fell. I threw it at him. Knocked him out. Then he started to bleed.
That's when Frank sent for us. We weren't able to stop the bleeding either. Frank wanted to give himself up, but we talked him out of it.
Who's we?
Eddie and me. Charlie there. Jen. Jen's the one who called for Doc Taylor.
By the time I got there, he was dead. It looked to me like self-defense. Mr. Matthews, I think all these people are wondering what's going to happen to them. I guess they've broken the law, all right. But morally, they haven't done anything wrong.
Well, that's up to the investigation to decide. Who was he, Wilkins? This man's a well-known criminal. He spent most of his life in jail. There's a $5,000 reward out for him, dead or alive. Now, you're going to tell me you killed him in self-defense and try to bury the body secretly and not even think about the reward?
I couldn't have accepted it.
Why not?
His real name was Wilkins. He was my son.
I'm sorry. There'll have to be a hearing. You stay here. I'm going to call the coroner.
Mr. Matthews?
Yeah?
You know everything now, Mr. Matthews. I ask you, did we do wrong?
Well, you broke the law. There's going to have to be a hearing. But the laws are made and administered by people like yourselves. They're human beings.
Patrol in action again next week. Until then, remember, leave blood at the Red Cross, not on the highway. This is Roderick Crawford saying, see you next week.